Hello and welcome to my third tutorial on DaVinci Resolve. On this one we are going to refine our edit a little bit. We're going to move our clips around, we are going to change the start and end points and sync it to music. So let's get straight to it. Okay, if we look at our timeline now, we've got night first and we've got day second. Well, that's a little bit strange, so why don't we move things around? To reorder our clips is extremely easy in the cut edit. We can literally just use this top bar, so we can drag, say, the jellyfish we want right at the end of the clip. We can just draw a box around them and drag them to the end of our timeline, like so. So now they're at the end. What else have we got? Where's our squid? Our squid we can also drag to the end. Let's have them right at the end. I like the squid. They can be our goodbye. We'll start with the mantis shrimp. And you can just organize these, dragging them around either one by one or selecting the box and dragging them where you see fit. Once we've got everything in order, we are going to need some music. So what we are going to do, we just click on to the media pool icon and we can just drag any music into here. We then drag this onto our timeline underneath our track. You see now the music's a lot longer than our video. Our video is the blue, audio is the green. So let's just source out the start and end points. Often any MP3 or music that you have, there's always like a second or so of quiet before it starts, so we can actually just trim that off. So we want it to start at the same time as the video. So we can just trim that off and then move that to the start. And we can then, using this timeline, go right to the end and literally click and drag the end point all the way back. Nyeong, missed it. To here, so it's the end. So now we have some music for our track. What we want to now do is sync up our track with the music. For those of you who are not musically trained, like most modern music these days has four beats
in a bar.
So normally at the start of every bar, there will normally be an accent of some sort, whether it be a cymbal, whether it be a bass drum or something like that. So we can edit our track to this point. You can actually even see it down here will be probably the second bar. So if we press play and count to four, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Okay, so that's two bars in, but that'd be a good place to stop. So we can now edit our track. We can make this, our first clip, a little bit smaller just by clicking on here until you see this icon and just dragging him back to the line. Now this one's in time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yet again, this line here is the start of our next like two bars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. This one you can't see so much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Maybe that tiny little peak there. It's roughly about here. Yet again, we can click. This is half the size clip. This is only 2 seconds now. It's fine, it's nothing special. And then 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Okay, so this one's a bit longer. That's fine, so it's a 6 second clip. Okay, we'll just do this for the rest of the clips now. Okay, then we get to the end, and we can just drag this one back. This time's changed a little bit. And there you have it. Our track is now top and tailed and edited to music. Thanks for listening. That's the end of this tutorial. Next one we'll be going into doing some transitions in between clips and also a bit of image stabilization. So thank you and hope you follow the series.